In this video, we'll cover Maya's dependency graph, which is an important feature you need to understand about Maya's scene structure. Like Softimage, Maya is a full 3D program that covers the complete creation process. The two programs, however, differ in how they were designed. Under the hood, Softimage has a node-based architecture that is modular. What you see in the interface, however, is a system of operators built on top of the node structure. For example, when you create a sphere in Softimage, properties are created for the object itself, as you can see in the Explorer. And if you deform it, the deform operator shows up in the object's operation stack. Maya is similar in that it is also built on a network of nodes called the dependency graph. It gets its name from the connections between the nodes, each one depending on another's information. Instead of being object-oriented as Softimage is, each object in Maya is actually a series of nodes. And unlike Softimage, this node graph is directly exposed in Maya's interface. You can view the graph in the Hypergraph Connections window, which shows the connections between all scene objects. If you switch to the hierarchical view, you see the hierarchy of objects in the scene, but without connections between objects. The combination of both hypergraph views is like the schematic view in Softimage, which shows both hierarchy and connections. The node editor, however, provides a more modern and a more familiar editor style, like the ice tree or render tree in Softimage. When you create a sphere in Maya, you can see that it's actually built from several nodes. A history node that contains the attributes that created the sphere, a shape node that stores the positions of the sphere's vertices, an initial shading group that stores the default material, and a transform node that determines the position, rotation, and scaling of an object. You'll notice that the transform node is the one named according to the object itself, whereas the geometry of the object has shape appended to its name. It also looks like the transform node is not connected to the other nodes, but that's because you need to see it in a different view. If you open the outliner, which is like the explorer in Softimage, and display shape nodes, you can see that the transform node is actually the parent of the shape node. In fact, when you select an object in the viewport, you're actually selecting the transform node plus the shape node. We'll explain the transform node a bit more when we cover hierarchies and groups in another video. If we use the Sculpt Geometry tool and deform the sphere in Maya, and then use the Smooth tool to add some smoothing, you can see that the nodes that are created for these operations are connected between the sphere's history and shape nodes. Each node in the graph has attributes which control how the node works, as you can see in the attribute editor. This editor shows you all the nodes for an object, and, as you guessed, you can edit their attributes here. You can also use the channel box, which is a more compact view that shows only the transform and shape nodes by default, plus any input or output nodes. You'll find it useful for animating attribute values, which we'll do in another video. Attributes for nodes are similar to how each operator or property set in Softimage has parameters that you can set in a property page. The different types of nodes in Maya are also similar to the different property sets and operators in Softimage. For example, the primitive history node is similar to an object's base or primitive property when it's created. The shape node is similar to an object's geometry operator. The render stats and object display attributes on the shape node give you similar options to an object's visibility property. The transform node is similar to an object's kinematics property. And the initial shading node plus the Lambert node are similar to the scene material property plus its default shader. So that's how each object is made up of nodes that are defined by attributes. Now let's look at a node's inputs and outputs when there are dependencies between objects. We'll revolve a curve around an axis to create a new surface with a cross-section in the shape of the curve. When you apply this operation to the curve, a new revolve node is created, which is similar to an operator in Softimage. In the node editor, click this icon to show the input and output connections. The revolve node has the shape of the curve as an input, and has the resulting surface shape as its output. The order of these actions or operations that are performed on an object is the construction history, which is generally the same idea as the construction history in Softimage. The revolve node is an operation that was performed on the surface, so it's an input in the surface's construction history, which you can also see in the channel box. Likewise, if you select the curve, you see that the revolve node is an output for it. If you reshape the curve, the resulting surface updates automatically because the changes cause a recalculation from this node to the last one in the chain. If you want to turn off the construction history so that it's not updated as you work, you can click the construction history icon in the status line. This is the same as working in immediate mode in Softimage. And similar to freezing an object's operator stack in Softimage, you can freeze an object's construction history in Maya so that all input nodes are removed. Choose Edit Delete by Type History. If you want to delete only non-deformer nodes in an object's history, you can choose the Non-Deformer History command. This deletes nodes that are downstream and upstream from your object's deformation nodes, and then bakes the remaining history into the object. This is useful when you want to delete modeling operations from your object's history that are slowing down your scene's recalculation time. If you select History before Deformers only, it deletes only the history upstream from the object's deformations. For example, you may want to use this option to keep modeling operations that are performed after skinning, but delete modeling operations that happen before the skinning. Similar to clicking the Freeze M button in Softimage to freeze only the operators in the modeling construction region. In Maya, you can mute nodes by temporarily disconnecting them in the graph. Right-click on the link and choose Break Connection. You can also reorder and reconnect nodes in Maya, which is similar to changing the order of operators in the stack in Softimage, but not quite as simple. For example, you can change the order of the tweak and smooth nodes so that the sphere is smoothed first and then deformed. Drag the output from the smooth face node to the input polymesh port on the tweak node. Then drag the output from the tweak node to the inmesh port on the shape node. This gives you different results because the vertices are in different positions, but this is just a simple example to show you how you can reorder nodes. Obviously, there are limits to which nodes you can reorder, as there are in Softimage, but certain operations are possible. In the next video, we'll look at how to customize Maya's layout to what you want.